Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 7th April, Sunday. On the front page, there is election related news, so you can skip it. On page 6, you have 9 polling stations for Brew voters in Mizoram. So this is regarding the Brew community. It has actually fled from Mizoram to Tripura. So there are steps being taken to bring them back to Mizoram too. So this alternate arrangement presently for elections has been made at Mizoram-Tripura border, where 15 special polling stations have been erected for the 12,081 Brew voters which are lodged in 6 relief camps in Tripura. So these polling stations were damaged in a thunderstorm, so now they have been these have been erected again. On page 8, you have family seeks official celebration of last Nizam's birth anniversary. So this is regarding the last Nizam of Hyderabad, the 7th Nizam. So the family members of Nawab Mir Usman Ali Khan, the 7th Nizam, have requested the Telangana government to organize his birth anniversary as an official event every year. So they say, in recognition of his umpteen contributions to transformation of Hyderabad into a modern city and his vision for the development of erstwhile Hyderabad state, they demand so. And below you have, will Neerkurunji bloom next season? So it is said recent wildfires could have wiped out all seeds of the endemic flower. So you should know about the Neerkurunji flower. It blossoms widely every 12 years. So last year there was a blossom. So now it would take place after 11 more years. On page 9 you have, UAE upset as government drags feet on air services deal. So here you can see it is said that passengers are suffering as Indian Airlines are blocking increase in flights from Gulf countries. So this is what UAE ambassador highlights. And this is all low earth satellites in reach of ASAT missile. So this is what the DRDO chief says, that extensive simulations have been conducted before the test, and he also said that the debris doesn't pose any threat to International Space Station. On international page you have, US to designate Iran's elite force as terrorist group. So this is regarding Iran's elite Revolutionary Guards Corps. So the USA has decided to designate this as a foreign terrorist organization. So Tehran warns of a tit-for-tat response too. So here you can see the earlier two, the relations between Iran and USA has been tense. In 2007, US Treasury had designated Iran's Revolutionary Guard Corps Quartz Force, its unit in charge of operations abroad, for its support of terrorism, and had described it as Iran's primary arm for executing its policies of supporting terrorist and insurgent groups. And now in 2019, it has decided to designate it as a foreign terrorist organization. It has still not been announced. And Iran says, if the Revolutionary Guards are placed on America's list of terrorist groups, we'll put the country's military on the terror blacklist next to Islamic State. So next to Islamic State, US military would be put as a terrorist organization by Iran. Then this is, H-1B visa cap for 2020 reached in 5 days, says USCIS. So this is US Citizenship and Immigration Services. It says that it started receiving petitions for H-1B visa on April 1, and the visa cap for 2020 has already been reached. It has, it has reached the congressionally mandated 65,000 H-1B visa cap for the financial year 2020. Then on business page you have, G20 must tackle root cause of trade tensions that threaten growth, European Union. So the G20 finance ministers meeting would take place soon. This is the world's 20 biggest economies. So European Union is also part of it. And in this meeting, EU is expected to tell the finance leaders from these, the 20 biggest economies, that they must all tackle the root cause of global trade tensions because they are putting global growth at risk. The meeting is going to take place in Washington on April 11 and 12. This is in the context of US-China trade war. So these tense negotiations to end the months-long trade war is important. It has rattled the global markets now. And this is India's imports from China decelerating, says report. So this is regarding India's imports from China, which has decelerated as a deceleration of 5% over the corresponding period a year ago. So this is the data regarding that. Also, you should know we have a huge trade deficit with China. It's a deficit of $46 billion now. Last year it was $53 billion, so it has come down 5%. Then on Sundays you have the FAQ coverage, frequently asked questions. So this is regarding cricket, and this is challenging electoral bonds. So this is regarding the electoral bonds, which are now, the arguments are being heard in the Supreme Court. So here the questions raised in this article is, have anonymous cash donations reduced with the scheme? Are there pitfalls in the system? So these are the questions to be answered here. And this is Namo TV's case. So this talks about Namo TV, which made its debut on 31st March. So it on direct to home DTH platforms. So there are several questions raised about its identity, ownership and content. Then on Sundays, you have the science and technology coverage. So here the important news is IIT Bombay's bacteria preferentially degrade aromatic compounds. So this is a unique bacteria strain which has been isolated by IIT Bombay's researchers from soil contaminants. So this is actually can be used to clean up toxic pollutants. So, you know, aromatic degrading bacteria first consume glucose before degrading aromatic compounds. So this strain of bacteria, so its food choice is completely reversed. So it prefers aromatic compounds over glucose. So this food preference comes from the suppression of glucose utilization at molecular level. So they have achieved this. So now aromatic compounds and organic acids are consumed simultaneously when by these bacteria, and this helps in cleaning up toxic pollutants. On the last page you have soon first photo of black hole. So scientists will unveil the picture of black hole at 6 global news conferences today. So the first ever photograph of a black hole, which is a breakthrough in astrophysics, has been proposed to be unveiled. So this will provide insight into black holes, which are considered celestial monsters. They have gravitational fields so intense that no matter or light can escape it. Then below you have climate change blights children's lives in Bangladesh. So there are around 12 million of children of Bangladesh who are living in and around rivers that regularly burst into banks. Another 45 million live in coastal areas regularly struck by cyclones. So climate change would have a significant impact on the lives of children, especially in Bangladesh. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Here the monthly compilations are also available. Even for the month of March, the monthly compilations have been uploaded. Plus also, you can download the daily current affairs PDFs on every day except on Sundays. So that is it. Thank you.